Greetings everybody, I'm Shujaat Ali from Medicose Lectures by Shujaat, and today we are going to talk about diseases of immune system, a very interesting topic of pathology. Focus on this word immune system. We came to know that it is basically a system which is helping us to protect our body from foreign invaders, from foreign attackers. So we have different parts in immune system, we have different immunities in immune system. First is innate immunity. As its first word innate shows that innate, it is present, it is always present, it is natural immunity that is present in body. We have second type of immunity which is acquired. There are two forms of acquired immunity, one is humoral immune response and one is cell mediated immune response. So we can acquire them, we can either acquire antigen or antibodies to protect our body from that disease, from that disease pathogens that we are infecting with. We also have T cells and B cells, thymus and bursa of Fabricius, CD4 cells, CD28 cells in immune system that are playing its roles. Hypersensitivity reaction. Look, our immune system mostly plays its protective role, but in some cases when it plays its destructive or injurious role, so we say that these reactions that are injurious, they are hypersensitivity reactions. So these are four types: immediate, say T cells mediated, immunocomplex mediated, and antibody mediated. Now, after discussing a brief intro, we are going to shift towards our main topic, which is diseases, which is pathology. So we have autoimmune diseases. Look, focus on this word autoimmune. In this autoimmune, antigens attack our own immune system. Our own antigens attack our own immune system. So we say that it is autoimmune diseases. It is autoimmune system diseases. First is immunological tolerance, in which unresponsiveness of antigen, as the word tolerance is depicting us that, induced by the exposure to the specific site. Antigen is unresponsive, so we say that it is immunological tolerance. In the same way, we have few more diseases which are systemic lupus erythematosus, which is organ characterized by vast array of antibodies as well as particular anti-nuclear antibodies, in which injury is basically caused by the deposition of various antibodies in that particular tissue. These antibodies came, these antibodies deposit in that particular tissue, and after their deposition we have developed a lupus, and we say that lupus, it is systemic lupus erythematosus. In the same way, we have rheumatoid arthritis. Most commonly we heard this word, rheumatoid arthritis. It is basically an autoimmune disease of joints, in which basically a swelling type is going to be occurring in joints. So that swelling is basically due to the extravascular tissues, in which we have blood vessels. So these tissues from lungs and heart also, they accumulate, and we say that this person is affecting from the rheumatoid arthritis. Of fourth point is SJOGRENS syndrome. It is basically a chronic disease characterized by dry eye and dry mouth that is resulting in devastating and destructive effect on our salivary glands and lacrimal glands. Furthermore, we have three main conditions. First is severe combined immunodeficiency syndrome. In this, immune system producing T and B lymphocyte immaturely in both humoral immune system as well as cell mediated. So in both cases, immune cells T and B, they are immaturely producing. Second is AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, as its name shows, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So in it, virus attacks our immune system, as a result our immune system fades off. Third is human immunodeficiency virus, HIV. HIV has its two forms, HIV-1 and HIV-2. It is basically a single-stranded RNA retrovirus. Single-stranded RNA retrovirus having two forms. HIV-1 and HIV-2. HIV-1 is basically restricted to America, and HIV-2 is basically to Asia and Southern Africa. So when I talk about the structure of this HIV, we basically have protease, we have spikes on it. For binding on HIV, we have GP120 proteins, and furthermore it will be binding with that of host in which it going to be enter, and then it will attack on the immune system. As a result, our immune system fades off. So it is basically caused due to the lack of hygiene, or due to the homosexuality, or due to affecting contact with fluids of infected person. So there we have the condition HIV due to this. So guys, this is my basic presentation on topic pathology of immune system, pathology of diseases of immune system. Hope you all understand it. Don't forget to subscribe Medicose Lectures by Shujaat. Thank you so much.